Ladies and gentlemen, let's get ready to rumble!
Introducing first, fighting out of the blue corner, wearing black, trimmed with gold, and weighing in at 236 pounds. He brings a professional record of 23-3, with one draw, 16 KOs. He's the pride of the USA Olympic boxing team in 1988 when he won the heavyweight gold medal. Ladies and gentlemen, representing the USA, former WBO World Heavyweight Champion, Merciless Ray Mercer. And his opponent across the ring, fighting out of the red corner, wearing white, trimmed with black, and weighing in at 247 pounds. He captured Olympic gold in 1988 when he represented Great Britain in the super heavyweight division. His professional record now stands at 28 victories with only one defeat. 24 of those 28 victories are by KO. Ladies and gentlemen, from East London, England, representing Great Britain, former WBC heavyweight champion of the world, Lennox Lewis.
Let's go, champ. Let's go, Ray. Come on, champ.
Good evening, gentlemen. You both received the rules early in the dress room by the New York State Athletic Commission. I expect you to obey these rules. Let's have a nice, clean fight. Touch gloves. Good luck to the both of you.
And Arthur Mercanti Jr. is referee, spelling out the instructions. We are ready to go. Lennox Lewis and Ray Mercer. You get a look at Mercer. Across the ring, 23-3-1. Very unusual position tonight. He lost a big payday 3 years ago to Jesse Ferguson. Now he could take a big one away from Lennox Lewis.
Without a doubt, this is the biggest fight of Lennox Lewis's career. He's got to perform here tonight in New York.
And Mercer is certainly going to be up for this and be right on him, knowing the opportunity at hand.
The size difference is there, but the big difference is the reach. Lennox Lewis has a 6-inch reach advantage. As you said earlier, Dave, if you don't use it, what's the point?
Well, we've seen him use it many times. And Mercer has a good jab, but if they both jab to their abilities with the reach, Lewis would win it. There he tries the right hand behind the jab.
Lewis is trying to set up that right hand right on Mercer's chin. He tried to go to the body also, but Lewis's legs are already kind of wide, which he's trying to get a little, like he doesn't have his balance. And that's not good if Mercer rushes him. He can't go back and get out of the way.
And that's what Emmanuel Stewart has been working on, Lennox Lewis's balance. And
keep
he's been saying how much better it is, but clearly we can see here in the first round, it's still one of his bugaboos.
Well, when the guys have their legs spread so far apart like that, seems like they're thinking half defense at the time that they're trying to throw the jab out, and they lose a lot of power. Mercer coming in, getting behind it, and this one shaping up to be a crisp-paced fight. Mercer very hungry so far.
From the outside, it becomes Lewis's fight. When Mercer gets inside, it's Mercer's fight. So we see who can put their will on the other man. Lewis has to keep Mercer away from him.
And when Mercer gets inside, he must capitalize.
Must punch.
Right now, Mercer can't get past that pole that Lennox Lewis has. Now you see him trying to work on the inside, going to the body.
Good uppercut by Mercer.
Good right hand by Lewis.
With a left hook and a right hand.
Could we have a slugfest?
They both realized the need to open up, because Mercer is not going to, at least in the early going, while he has his stamina, let Lewis dictate from outside.
Why is it when I look at Lennox Lewis, I think of Tommy Hearns at about age 34? There's something about the way he fights and moves, the way his legs are,
no legs,
his balance, yeah. He's always trying to hit you with that one big bomb.
Mercer goes downstairs, literally, a little bit low.
Good spot, though, Dave, because he's trying to take those legs away. If Mercanti lets him get away with it,
do it if you're Ray Mercer?
No point taken, no foul.
Mercer is already planning to try and get into the later rounds. That's why these body shots do the difference. Lewis, on the other hand, he's just going for the head. He's trying to knock him out early.
Well, an interesting first round for these two guys. Good strategies clearly outlined. Round one ends.
Stepping up. You get your gimmick like you hear a big whack. Nice. And now the other's gonna work too, he's holding your neck.
Okay.
Breathe deep, Ray. Relax a little more. Breathe deep, breathe deep, breathe deep. Breathe deep. He's a big deep one, that's it. Alright, just don't let him set up.
Okay.
Keep him going.
Okay.
Relax now, okay?
That's something different. Usually you take the mouthpiece out of a guy's mouth instead of leaving it in as he gets some oxygen.
Now we start the second round. Lennox Lewis in the white trunk, Ray Mercer in the black. Pretty intriguing opening round as Lewis tried to bomb away from the outside and Mercer tried to get inside. The crowd loving this because it has opened up and become a pretty good offensive fight thus far.
And Emmanuel Stewart, right away telling Lennox Lewis between rounds, relax. You can sense he's very nervous here. And that can drain a lot more from a fighter than getting hit with a right hand.
He needs to be set. And Mercer's camp in there. Tommy Parks telling him, don't let him get set. That's a key. Don't let him get anything off in there as Lewis, with the reach, can find a lot of power as well.
And Mercer is letting himself be set up for that right hand by not moving his head. Lennox Lewis is parring with the jab, trying to drop the right. Even if it doesn't do damage, it could bust Ray Mercer's face up. So he's got to move his body and head a little bit.
Yeah, Ray Mercer has right now, he's trying to run through Lennox Lewis rather than bob and weave and work his way through. He wants to get inside so badly.
And you can't miss Ray Mercer's head.
No movement from the knees up.
It's also the style of a guy who relies on his chin, as Mercer has been able to do throughout his career. They take your shot, I'm coming in right from mine.
Now remember when Lennox Lewis got knocked out by Oliver McCall from a right hand, but Mercer doesn't seem to be in position to throw it.
Gets one going there. That is what he will look for.
Now see, Mercer should be working the body right now. He should be pounding the ribs until the referee pulls him off. That's a wasted opportunity for Mercer.
It's hard enough to get inside. That's the first big battle, getting inside the jab.
He heard him.
He scores. Mercer backing Lewis up. Lewis holding on. Good right, chopping right by Mercer. Uppercut. Lewis in trouble. Coming right by Mercer again. Going for it now.
Watch the Mercer left hook if he can throw it.
How many opportunities will he have? So he went all for it on that first shot.
We're going to find out tonight, gentlemen, if Lennox Lewis wants to be a champion. He's going to have to take this from Ray Mercer. And obviously there's no title on the line, but to go down the road, he's got to go through Ray Mercer.
It's already a street fight and he has been challenged here. Good message being sent by the right hands of Ray Mercer in round two. And this one really heating up nicely. Mercer and Lewis come to the end of round two.
Shape you're in, okay? He's not in the shape. You won that round a couple good shots tonight. I give him that round, so I got it dead even. But he's not in the shape that you're in. Keep winning. What you have, you get hit with a jab because you're jabbing, and I told you you're jabbing with your right hand over here, and that's how you're getting caught with jab. Keep your right hand up higher. He's catching you with jab because your right hand is over here while you're jabbing, and you're getting hit. Keep your right hand up a little higher and watch. That's what he's catching.
Well, Lewis had things going outside until Mercer changes it. Jabs behind the jab, then scores with the nice right hand. Jabs his way in again and hooks behind the Lewis jab. Two jabs by Lewis that didn't get to Marvin.
All right, so now Mercer here. Scored. When you get him in the corner, you whack him with this. Whack him money.
Okay.
Get those elbows down. Come in.
Come
in.
Come on, please.
Get tired.
Get tired.
Get down. Let's go, gentlemen.
And we start the third round. Lennox Lewis and Ray Mercer has set a good pace thus far.
Emmanuel Steward wasted no time in performing psychological surgery after that round on Lennox Lewis. He told him, Ray Mercer's tired, you won the round. Emmanuel Steward knows what happened in that round. That was a very pivotal round in this fight.
Hey, trainers need to have a little Pinocchio in them. Get their fighter moving. Get more out of their fighter. And they have to know when to throw it in there.
Look at Lennox Lewis's legs again. Again, wide. He's trying to feel the canvas because he's been rocked a few times in that last round. Mercer's legs, very compact. Looks like a fire plug coming toward him.
Lewis's legs have been wide the whole fight here.
Emmanuel Steward did a terrific selling job on the media all week long, saying what a new fighter Lennox Lewis was from a skill standpoint, working on his balance, learning to put his punches together. We haven't seen it thus far tonight. He's had some good moments, but Ray Mercer is starting to exert his will.
If Mercer can land an overhand right with Lewis's legs so far apart, by the time the signal gets to his legs to get out of there, he'll be on his face.
Is Mercer really trying to get that going and fighting tactically here and jabbing his way in? We talked about Mercer's underrated jab coming in. At least it's functional enough to get him some room. And if he gets the room, he's trouble.
Boy, Dave, Mercer just whistled an uppercut or just missed Lewis's chin.
And Mercer gets home with the right hand. He needs to do some serious work early, remembering that in past fights, he has faded a bit.
I'd like to see Lennox Lewis use a little bit more of his boxing skills here. I mean, I know that he can punch with his right hand, but he's got to keep that jab working, double and triple it. And to me, it almost looks like he's trying to avoid getting fatigued too quickly.
He's being out jabbed at times by the smaller man.
And Mercer, is, as we said earlier, does not move his hand. It's right there. He needs to throw the left jab and step back if you feel him coming towards you. Keep that distance. Use that 6 inches you have. If you're not, you know what, you might as well be 5'11". Not throwing, just pivoting and wind up getting popped.
Battle of jabs continued, and they shot some big bombs at each other. As round three has been one in which Mercer continues to pursue.
Lennox Lewis
on the outside.
Sorry, Dave. Lennox Lewis also another heavyweight who's gone through a succession of trainers. He's on his third one.
Well, Mercer coming back strong behind the missed jab by Lewis and scores with the right hand. And Mercer's right hand has been a good weapon thus far as round three finishes up.
Yeah, let the sex go, champ. Let that short
take hook. Take them left hook. Body in here. Start making your...
Yeah. Whack them. They go to the body. Right? Doing a good job, right?
I really can't figure out what Lennox Lewis' strategy is. He should be using his boxing skills. Should be using his left.
We start the fourth round. Lewis in the white and Ray Mercer in the black trunks. And Tony, I think he wanted to be outside in this fight. And Mercer took some of his confidence away by landing those bombs to the head. And it's caught him in between styles.
I think he's hit Mercer with a couple of his best punches. Nothing's happened. And I don't know if he has a plan B.
Also, let's give credit to Ray Mercer.
Yes.
He landed five or six to start this round. That has a lot to do with what he's able to do in the follow-up position.
There's Lewis firing the right hand. Mercer keeping the jab popping here.
And Lennox Lewis, also like Tommy Hearns, likes to carry the low left.
Well, pitch bell disaster tonight. That's the bat is found. Now Mercer gets caught with some uppercuts. That chin just got its first test. The legendary Mercer chin.
That shot would have taken out a lot of heavyweights. Oh, just missed a home run uppercut.
Mercer tries to come back. He went down against Evander Holyfield for the first time in his career. Can't take too many chances, even with a Mercer-like chin.
See, this is where Lennox Lewis is not well schooled. You have the man hurt. You have the advantage. What are you fighting him on the inside for? You're not an inside fighter. Now you're fighting with Ray Mercer's strength.
Yeah, which could be an uppercut for Mercer. It could be a chopping right hand for Mercer. So, there's Lewis giving away his edge as he tries to parlay. Good uppercut again. Two punches inside by Lewis. And you know,
oh, he walked into a big right hand. Wow. Almost ran into that right hand. Glancing blow by Ray Mercer.
There's a big eagle involved in fighters, too, in the sense that they like to think they can slug on the inside, even if they're better suited for outside. But you see that Mercer can come back, given the inside opportunity. This has been a good round.
A little veteran trick there.
Mercer missing over the top, trying to get him with that right hand. Lewis with a short left hook. You know, Mercer could step to the side as Lewis was firing one and pop his own right hand home.
Lennox Lewis, the fourth round, his mouth is already hanging open. And I got to wonder how much nervousness. Here comes Ray Mercer.
Mercer really piling it on here. Good shot by Mercer.
Mercer
he tries to put some speed with it here. Some good speed and power by Mercer. Mercer came to fight, and Lewis had some good guts when he needed it there. And round four, an excellent one.
Lennox Lewis is exhausted, Dave.
Lewis really nails Mercer, test the chin with a terrific uppercut, and then puts two nice shots behind it, the left hook and the right cross, but he's too close inside, so Ray Mercer gets another chance at him, lands the right hand, and Lewis did not put him away as he had the chance to there. What a nice round. So we start the fifth. Lewis and Mercer unloading in round four.
Lewis is doing some damage with those punches, but even after he lands them, I can see Mercer just waiting to counter or just start an offensive attack, because Lewis is leaving himself wide open.
Well, the most fundamental mistake he's making is dropping his hands, particularly after he jabs. I thought Lennox Lewis won that round. In fact, I thought it was his best round of the fight, and I think Emmanuel Stewart was right. I don't think that was false psychology was feeding him in the corner, Dave.
You take away the shots that Mercer landed, and you've got the good combinations fired by Lewis, tremendous uppercut, and then two big bombs behind it, and then he answered at the end. And there's a low blow warning for Lennox Lewis, although he's trying to settle into an attack here. Right. Not a bad development either way.
No. I don't fault Lennox Lewis for going downstairs to Ray Mercer. You're not always going to hit the target.
And he didn't lose a point for it, so he was simply warned on it. And Lewis does need that shot, and he did it from a distance where he could get leverage on it and not leave himself open there.
But also, I think it's a good move by Arthur Mercanti Jr. to let both fighters know he's not going to allow that type of thing. He's going to stay in control of the fight, and he wants a good, clean, hard fight, which we've had through four rounds.
Yeah, he's right not to take points. You'd hate to see points deducted when two guys are giving everything like they are here. Left hook by Lewis from the outside. Well, Mercer continues to fire the left hook as he gets inside, and Lewis fighting Mercer's fight.
So this is the type of fight that Georgie Benjamin used to say about when this fight looked better, the next one, the veteran trainer would say that. Lennox Lewis needs to stop trying to be pretty. If you have to win a boring 10-round decision, that should be plan B. Stop trying to go for a spectacular knockout and risk getting knocked out yourself.
Well, Lewis was trying to improve on what he had done in round four, So he opened up a little more in round five, but he will play to Mercer's strength.
When it comes to chins, Ray Mercer is the Marvin Hagler of the heavyweight division. He must have poured, God must have poured concrete that thing when he made it.
That is the cement chin of the heavyweight division, without question. And Mercer proceeds behind his jab. Interestingly, if Lewis fights outside effectively, he's the only one that can win. If they fight inside, either guy can win.
And you wonder if Lewis realizes, hey, I just hit him with five of my best shots. Nothing happened. Let me just stay outside.
So round five coming to a conclusion. Halfway home for these heavyweights.
Okay, this is it, man, okay? If you let him go, it's going to be over with.
Yep. Take deep breaths. Just let your hands go, mouthpiece.
And you can look at Lennox Lewis.
Okay, let him go this round. It's over with you, let him go.
Device is used to try to reduce the swelling there, which Ray Mercer's corner believes is a big problem for Lewis as we start round six.
Both of Lewis's eyes are swelling.
Well, I'll tell you what, when Lennox Lewis entered the ring tonight, he had gobs of Vaseline dripping from his cheekbones. Right away, you could see that they knew that was going to be a problem in this fight. I mean, when you have that much Vaseline before the fight starts,
you probably got cut in the dressing room. And Mercer with those slashing tight punches and heavy shots, he's been able to get those big bombs into that area. And Lewis is helped by fighting inside often. It has been intriguing because Lewis has been good from the outside and sometimes at moments effective inside. With the uppercuts and strong combinations, he should be moving in and out more then.
And on the flip side, Ray Mercer's been good from the outside.
But you'd wonder if Ray Mercer had another level to pick it up, be a little faster, be a little more aggressive, what kind of damage he would do.
He doesn't have that gear though.
Yeah.
And he needs that gear tonight.
But see, right here, when you're in that, I mean, that's when you have a chance for 3 points in a round. The guy's right in front of you. Just four-punch combination, you do something. Now he's getting hit because he's outside, not doing anything.
Well, two right hands by Lennox Lewis.
And Lewis starting to move as well. And then the left hook by Lewis. And Lewis starting to put some punching and movement together for the first time in this bout.
You guys get the feeling that Ray Mercer's gas tank is starting to, that light is starting to flash a little bit, getting on empty?
No question, he's slowing down a little bit.
He has hit Evander Holyfield territory here. Same type of, same point in the fight. He's done some very good work through the five rounds, but Lewis trying to turn it on. Mercer, always dangerous, though, and lands an uppercut and a left hook. Now he backs Lewis up in a good right hand. A big chance for
Mercer. He rocked him.
He needs to capitalize on these chances, which we talked about earlier. There may not be too many for Ray Mercer of this nature in the course of the bout. And he came on nicely here.
I wonder if Lennox Lewis isn't carrying some weight he shouldn't be coming into this fight at 247, the heaviest of his career. He does have a big frame, obviously, 6'5". Looks like he carried the weight fairly well, but you got to wonder what effect that's having on his conditioning.
Sounds like he's suffering from the Riddick Bowe disease.
What he might do right now to be 237.
Nobody can eat that much, Tony. Never seen that man attack a plate of ribs.
Yep.
Wow, Riddick Bowe. Wow, whistling uppercut thrown from the outside by Lewis. Dangerous punch to throw.
Shades of Buster Douglas left at Holyfield.
And no follow-up for Mercer as round six ends, and both guys have their moments.
You're behind on points. He's out punching you. That's that simple. When you get a guy get a good body like that, you've got to come back and win that round back. You see, simply because he was exhausted after that, but you never pushed him after that. You got to let yourself go. Okay, let your shots go. If you keep letting them go, regardless of whether you're missing or not, you're going to knock him out at that time. This man is tired. He's spitting up.
Well, Lewis started the round strongly.
Thank you, sir.
And Mercer able to answer. And there, after he missed two, he was able to turn Lewis inside. And Lewis went straight back. And you see the fatigue on Lennox Lewis's face as Mercer comes in. Had Lewis shown any lateral movement there at all, guys, he's out of trouble.
Doesn't have the legs, Dave.
Doesn't know how to grab, basic boxing 101, when hurt, grab.
But I tell you what, he appears like he's recovered from that knockout loss in the call. He's taken some big shots here tonight.
Been hit with some big bombs, come back. Round 7 scheduled for 10. A good battle of attrition unfolding between Lennox Lewis and Ray Mercer.
And that time you heard Emmanuel Stewart in the corner telling it like it is. You're behind on points. Going into the 7th round, he isn't about to BS his fighter.
Well, Emmanuel Stewart went from salesman to realist. And a good trainer has to know when to do that.
Certainly Emmanuel, one of the best technicians in the game of boxing.
Yeah, it's amazing that with technology, you get into the corners, which you never could years ago, when that stuff was all being said, and you realize that some fighters really will benefit from it. They'll get taken to another level, they'll believe they're doing well.
But what upset Emmanuel Stewart, Dave, was that Lennox Lewis did not recognize that Ray Mercer was tired in the middle of that round after Lewis started out quickly and didn't pour it on a little bit more. And then what happened? Ray Mercer came back with those right hands and uppercuts.
And you know, with Ray Mercer's heart, he will be back. If he's got the conditioning, he will take the shots he's got.
He learned something, though. If the fighter was tired, forget about the head, whack him to the body. And that's what Lewis has been doing so far in this round, working the body, just trying to sap that last bit of energy out of Ray Mercer.
Good right hand here now as Mercer coming along and Lewis holding on. Lewis pouring it on. These guys take turns going at each other, and when one fighter really gets in trouble stamina-wise, the other fighter is on top of him.
Step back now. Looks like Lennox Lewis is taking a breather after being aggressive early in the round.
I think that both of these guys have at times hit a wall, and they're trying to now win the round with spurts as opposed to sustained action earlier. And these are important rounds. You have to steal some without a lot of effort to get a decision.
This is a very close fight.
It's going to be very intriguing on those cards. It's really going to come down to what style the judges favor. Do they like an attacking Mercer type inside, or do they like Lewis outside?
It's kind of scary. Lennox Lewis is giving Ray Mercer every chance to knock him out. He gets inside, doesn't keep his hands up, and Mercer's trying to get up one good shot, even though he's getting pounded.
Well, this was a good round for Lennox Lewis, especially the last part. Round 7 is history.
He just got to go like that all the way now. We can't lose no more rounds. Gotta push yourself. Get off first. Don't wait till he punches. You get off first. You got these next 3 rounds. You got to win all of them to win a decision, okay? The max time was a
dog fight. The guy's tired.
Okay? He's been here for.
Okay.
Okay, the guy's tired. Ray, fight this guy. Don't let him throw them 3 or 4 punches.
Okay.
He's stealing around if he does that.
Okay.
Now. Did Lewis steal things here at the end of the 7th? Good clubbing right hand. Goes downstairs. Nice uppercut. 5 shots.
Unanswered.
When Lewis puts combinations together, he can do it faster than Mercer. He can get more in.
Mercer has to take a lot of punishment just to get that one shot off.
Well, guys, we go into the 8th round of a very tight fight. How do you have it?
I've got Ray Mercer up by 1 point.
And I got Lewis up by 3.
All right.
Well, now we know what our preferences are as judges.
John Saraceno likes the inside style. Tony Page likes it outside. And very possibly the judges might have that same change in opinion there.
There's Lennox Lewis giving Ray Mercer a chance to win his fight. Doesn't use his reach, doesn't push it off.
Now, Ray Mercer has been motivated throughout this entire fight. Now, here in round 8, this is where we're into trouble against Evander Holyfield. Went down and signaled a turning point in a fight in which he was right there. So let's see if he builds on that and learned anything from it.
Also, I believe that even though I have Ray Mercer ahead in the fight, he's not going to win a close decision here. I just don't see that happening. There's too much on the line for Lennox Lewis.
Well, left hook by Mercer. Yeah, you would feel that he would need to win. Maybe by two or three to get the nod. And over the course of her career, a lot of these decisions come full circle. We go back to the Marion Wilson fight where he had more on the line and he got the call. And now the referee will bring the fighters together. Talk about fair play a little bit here. Mercer hits off the break. Nice.
Lennox Lewis is hurt.
Lewis is in trouble. He's wobbling. Now, can Mercer find something with it? There are only brief windows of opportunity when each guy gets hurt, and neither guy is able to follow up. Now, Lewis was a recipe for disaster right there, but Mercer only had 5 seconds to do it, and he could not finish it.
In the background, we see the Union Jack flag flying from England and the crowd chanting USA, and both of these fighters have a little bit of international history. They fought not each other, but they were both gold medalists at Korea. Seoul,
1988, and now they find themselves in this matchup at critical stages of their careers 8 years later. Mercer trying to save his, and Lennox Lewis trying to save a date with Mike Tyson. A clubbing right by Lennox Lewis, and this is a really sweet fight. Momentum shifts all around here.
If both these warriors are standing at the bell following the 10th round, one of them is going to be very unhappy when the decision's announced.
Yeah, they both have had moments.
You can really almost make an argument for either guy. It's that close.
It is a close fight.
And Lewis on the outside here. Mercer continuing to pound. Good jab. Uppercut by Lewis. And round 8 goes into the books.
Keep boxing and putting, looking good, okay? Don't worry about fouls. Put the shots together and box it. He's made these next 2 rounds badly, okay? Just like he was finished up, bang, 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 and moving the boxing him in. Make him have to use his feet while he's tired. Now, you understand? You got to punish on out.
What a man.
You got the box with his
clown.
You only got one more. There's not 12
nice
rounds here, okay?
Nice.
He's looking good with the punches. Boxing, now moving. Make him have to move.
His leg, he's more tired than you, Ray. Ray. All you gotta do,
Tommy Chan's right, do it.
Double jab him.
Okay.
Then the right hand, the big right hand, you had him out, you help him up. Hit him next time.
Make him use his legs while he's tired now, okay? Okay, let your shots go, don't hesitate so much. Using your legs. Second jab, gentlemen.
Let's go,
second
jab.
And we start the 9th round. Ray Mercer, Lennox Lewis. 2 rounds to go. Dave Fontempo along with Tony Page and John Saraceno at Madison Square Garden in New York. A fight that would figure to be very close on the scorecards at the end.
And regardless what happens, Ray Mercer was an Army sergeant. I think he's an officer tonight.
He really has stepped up and pounds away to the head there with a right hand on Lennox Lewis. Mercer has had his share of close decisions in recent years. Came up with a very close one over Marion Wilson in 1994, which preserved a date in Hong Kong, which never took place. The Jesse Ferguson fight, in which he lost the payday with Riddick Bowe. He also lost to Larry Holmes in some big moments. And a point you made, John, about him being a better underdog seems to have come true again tonight.
Look at Lennox Lewis. He's a little too square up when he's facing Mercer. He's just asking for a right hand down him, right down the middle.
And Mercer might be saying, I'm too tired to give it to you. This comes down now to who went the heavy bag a little more, who did the extra road work. Is this what boiled down to stamina?
You know, Emmanuel Stewart told Lennox Lewis he had to have these last 2 rounds, but he is boxing very cautiously here with the jab. I wonder if he thinks he can just outbox him for 2 rounds. He'll get out of here with a decision.
I guess he figures that if he can stay outside, he can win the rounds with a little less effort than being inside and trading on Mercer's turf. If Mercer doesn't hit you with some loud shots, the styles of the fight would suggest that Lewis can get it.
I still see a lot of work that has to be done on Lennox Lewis. It's just he's not polished yet for a guy at that age and as many fights as he's had.
You know what?
He doesn't seem to follow up opportunity.
I think he's a finished product. What we see is what we're going to get with Lennox Lewis. This is the guy you're going to see fight Mike Tyson if he gets past Ray Mercer eventually. He's not going to be any better than this.
You wonder if Don King is going to win. Maybe we should fight him.
Well, 30 seconds to go in round 9. And the fight has slowed here as Lennox Lewis wants to get out of town from the outside. And Ray Mercer wants to get inside, but is so fatigued at this point, he has gotten very little on his shots.
And the one thing Mike Tyson has that Ray Mercer does not possess is fast hands.
And the power to make him pay for those mistakes.
Keeping his hands down low, back straight up.
This round. We're going to take this round.
You've got to win this round to win the fight.
You've got to win it. You can't win it by moving. You've got to let the punches go. You can't take them home. Let them go, Lennox. You're holding on to them. Let them fly. Let the shots go. You got to talk to yourself and push yourself. This is the last round. You've got to win this round. Okay.
How bad you are?
That's the inch bar. We're inch bar. You first round.
All right.
Last round, champ. How bad you are?
Just go to him. That's just the last round. Don't give him this round.
Don't give
him 20. Yeah. All you got to do is keep punching.
You get close, you go 3 and 4 punches. And then keep turning. And keep turning them.
You've got to let them go. It's all up and up. If you don't win this round, you blow it.
They said, let them
anybody else.
That's round and we're going.
Huh?
Okay, no more water now.
He can't beat you.
Okay.
This is, and you can feel it, the 10th round between Lennox Lewis and Ray Mercer. It has gone back and forth. Excellent opportunities for both guys.
Emanuel told Lennox, let the hands fly. Stop boxing. He's still boxing, though.
I think Mercer is going to win this fight. He's got to have this round.
Yeah, I think so, too. And Lennox Lewis may have had the easiest round in the last, only because there was very little punching done. He was on the outside. He looked to be the aggressor and may have stolen it.
I think so.
Ray Mercer has to suck up whatever he's got now. Double jab, get in, and make it the inside rumble that it was earlier.
And Davey, Lennox is employing the same strategy he did in round 9. That is to box, show some lateral movement. Oh, just missed with a right uppercut. Almost caught Ray Mercer lunging forward with his head down.
Not a bad idea by Lewis to stay outside. Now, Ray Mercer hasn't really had anything going in a couple of rounds. And fighters sometimes will save themselves for the final round. And I'll take the round before off. And Mercer's going to need one more shot.
Ray really looked very, very fatigued. As exhausted as Lewis looked in his corner after 9 rounds, Ray Mercer looked like a weary soldier in there. And he's leading with his head leaning forward, which is asking for the uppercut.
And he got it. Maybe one big difference in this bout is that Lewis seems to have caught his second win. Mercer never really got his. Ray Mercer continues to be a pesky pain in the neck for Lennox Lewis, who has so much to lose and may pull it out with a big spurt, but he has certainly put his position at risk.
And also, like Tim Witherspoon, some people might make the case, why would you want to fight a guy like Ray Mercer?
Well, then maybe Ray Mercer and Witherspoon should fight in the fight that nobody else wants.
That's a new title, it sounds like.
And Ray Mercer had this one within his grasp, still may get it, but in the last 2 or 3 rounds has faded.
And he got rocked. Lewis got rocked coming in.
Now the difference, you were talking, John, about a Tyson versus a Lewis. When Tyson rocks him, he'll find another punch.
Mike's got those fast hands and like nobody probably in heavyweight history. And heavyweights are not used to seeing punches come that fast. 10 seconds to go.
Well, it has been an excellent heavyweight battle. Crowd pleaser. They might even get up on their feet when this is over. They should. Lennox Lewis pulling away in 8, 9, 10. Should be enough, but we'll see. Second half of the fight, especially a strong one for Lennox Lewis, who showed perhaps that he could outwill Ray Mercer and still leave other heavyweights salivating about fighting him.
I don't know if Lennox Lewis is ready to fight anybody in a couple of months. The way his eyes swelled up from this fight, he might need some time off. A step aside money might start to look pretty good all of a sudden.
He might be best off to watch Tyson on TV himself.
Mm-hmm.
But Lennox Lewis did show that when it came crunch time, he could hang in there, take a big punch. Now, Ray Mercer is a good, solid puncher. Let's face it, his last four fights, he hasn't stopped anybody.
Like Dave said, he's a pest.
He's not a pure power puncher, but he's got a terrific chin, as we said earlier.
But his punches did some damage if you look at Lewis's face.
So they add up the scorecards. All types of possibilities. And in boxing, if you preserve what you have, whether it's a win or a draw, it seems like nobody really takes you to task on it.
I think if this is a draw, it kind of favors Mercer, because Lewis was supposed to win and win big.
It helps Mercer's career, but it probably won't hurt Lewis that much. He won't lose the payday against Tyson or his position for that payday by having a loss here. He gets a draw.
But could the WBC, where he's the mandatory challenger for Tyson's title, argue that with a draw, he is no longer? I mean, let's face it. We know how rules come and go.
They could. They could. They usually don't. They could. They usually don't after a draw like this. But we'll see if the draw happens first. Lewis had himself quite a strong finish.
I had Lewis winning by 1 point.
I had Lewis winning by 2 points.
But you know what? If you made the argument that Ray Mercer won the fight tonight, I wouldn't have a hard time disagreeing with you.
If you made the argument, he would win it early.
Yeah.
Early in the fight, he was very strong.
He did fade.
The concern, however, we'll get it now.
Before we go to the scorecards here at Madison Square Garden, how about a round of applause for these two heavyweights, two Olympic gold medal champions that came here to fight tonight. We go to the scorecards. Melvina Latham scores the bout 95-95 even. Luis Rivera scores the bout 96-95. George Colon scores the bout 96-94 for the winner on a split decision. Lennox.
And the risk that he took in this bout did not come back to haunt him as he gets a majority decision.